Hello everyone, hope you're all doing well. Welcome to my channel and welcome to another video. My name is Diana. On my channel, what I basically talk about is anything that has to do with migrating to the UK as a registered nurse. I do share tips on basic lifestyle here in the UK. In this particular video, I'm going to share with you tips on how you can build and improve upon your credit score. So what I'm going to talk about is what credit score is all about and share tips on how you can start building your credit score as a newly migrant here in the UK. So someone might be wondering what a credit score is. So in simple terms, credit score is like a financial credit history that you have built over a certain number of years, and it's represented in like figures which would actually give lenders a fair idea of how your financial history is and how credible you are, that they can trust that if they give you a loan, you would pay back. So it normally ranges, credit score normally ranges between 0 and 999. So a good credit score will be any score between 961 up to 999. So that will be like an excellent credit score. So it ranges between fair, good, and excellent. So a score of 961 to 999 is an excellent credit score. So if you go to a bank to borrow money or request for a loan, they will definitely check your credit history over a certain number of years and then check your credit score. So if you have that excellent credit score, then any bank will definitely be happy to give you a loan because they know that you are credible, and so definitely you're going to pay back if they give you any amount of money. So this is what basically I'm going to be talking about. So I would also be sharing my experience and what I've used over the years to build my credit score. So the first thing you need to do is to register to vote. So if you're living in this country legally, then you have the right to vote. You are eligible to vote. So what you need to do is to go onto the UK government website, and then you enter your details, your name, your date of birth, the country you migrated from, and all that. You also have to put in your UK address. So that is where you're living. And once you're done with this registration, they will send a letter confirming that you are now eligible to vote. So if there's any election going on in any area, you can also partake. So how does this come in when we talk about credit score? So as you enter all of these details, your name, your address, the country you migrated from, your permanent, your date of birth, and all of these details are added up to your credit history. After 30 days, this will improve your credit score because at least it confirms that indeed you are a real person living in the country legally in a particular permanent address, not just anybody who is like randomly in the country, you know. So at least somebody can trust you, a lender can trust you with their money. So this is one of the most important ways that you can build your credit score. I didn't know this until recently, so I'll put the link to the UK government website where you can go on, and then you enter your details. It will send you a confirmation when the registration goes through. So another means you can use in building up or improving your credit score is setting up direct debits. So what this means is, for instance, if you have payments, like monthly payments you make, instead of you transferring the money every month, you can set up direct debits. So that automatically, the moment any money hits your account, the payment is made. So for instance, if you know when you're going to receive your salary, you can use payment of your rent as a direct debit. So you just enter a certain amount. For instance, if your rent is £500 every month, you can set up that as a direct debit in your account so that whenever your salary hits your account, the £500 will be deducted automatically to your landlord or your landlady. Also, you can set up direct debit for payment of bills like electricity. So for instance, if you're living in an apartment where you have to pay all these bills yourself, you can set up a direct debit for payment of maybe electricity, gas, water, council tax. So this actually helps you, relieve you of you having to remember all of these dates. So if you are certain that maybe by the end of the month, like 29th of every month, money is going to surely hit your account, that's your salary, you can set up the direct debit for maybe 30th or even the first of every month. So on the first of every month, at least you have enough in the account. So automatically the electricity bill, the council tax and everything goes out straight away without you even having to remember and make those payments on your own. Because if you delay in making payments, it actually affects the credit score negatively, which will not be good at all. Because if you delay even one payment, it kind of affect the credit score, and we don't want that. So if you don't want to like keep on remembering when to pay bills, it saves you time and it also builds your credit score. So if you've not done that before, if you still make payments every month by transferring money to your landlord or make payments to whatever payment that you do make, just make sure you set up direct debit. So you go onto your phone, your app, if it's Barclays, HSBC, whichever bank you save with. If you cannot even set up the direct debit, you can call them, you let them set it up for you. You choose the date, the time, and the amount, and automatically the payments go in so that you don't really have to do anything. And then it helps build your credit score. So if you are a registered nurse, you can also set up direct debit to pay your annual nursing and midwifery council registration fee. You know, every year we do pay like £120 just to keep you on the register. So once you make the first payment, if you've recently arrived and paying it for the first time, they will ask if you want to set up direct debit. I would advise that you click on yes, so that they will take your bank details, and the following year they will just take the amount straight away without you even, because it's so easy to forget to, pay that £120 every year. You might forget. So once you have that set up, it saves you that, you know, having to remember, and then also that builds your credit score. So another way you can improve your credit score is by maybe having a mobile phone contract. So for instance, if you wish to buy a new phone, you could have the money in your account, all right, to pay it upfront. But if you wish to build up your credit score, you can use this as a means of building a credit score. And what you can do is, instead of paying the money outright, what you can do is you can let them spread the cost over a certain number of months or years, depending on how you want it. So it could be spread for you over 24 months, 36 months, 12 months, depending on how much you can afford to pay every month. So with that, they will deduct the money from your account every month until the number of months is over. So I bought Samsung Galaxy Ultra with Samsung. I bought it directly from the Samsung. So what I did was I just paid a deposit of £419 and they spread the rest for me over 24 months. So every month I have a certain amount of money that I pay, and this is going to build my credit score because I decided to pay it for over 24 months. So that is a very, very good way of building your credit score. So as I mentioned before, I made purchase of Samsung phone, and instead of paying the money outright, I just let them spread the cost over a period of 24 months, and that's a good way of building a credit score. So I made an initial deposit of £119 and I spread the rest over a period of 24 months, as you can see on the screen. So far I've made payments of 740.23 out of the 190. So I'm just going to show you the plan over that 24 period. So this is the payments I've completed, and as you can see on top here, I made a deposit of 119.90. So since then, they've been deducting £36.49 from my accounts every month. So I always make sure that on the 5th of every month, I have that amount in the account so that they can deduct it. If they don't, I don't have that amount, it will go against my credit score. So 36.49 should always be in my account at least, so that they can make the deduction. And what I'm due to pay next, this is showing upcoming payments. So then again, 36.49 is going to be deducted every month from October up until April 2022. That is when I'll make the final payment of 239. By then, I would have made the payments for the total cost of the phone. So that's a good way that I've been able to build my credit score since last year, because that was when I purchased the phone. You just have to make sure that whenever there is due, you have amount in your account, because if you don't have money in your account as at the time they need to deduct, that actually affects your credit score. That's not a good thing. So if you want to actually, you can also go to the mobile, the network providers. They will give you the phone together with data, airtime, internet, you know, and you would also definitely have a certain amount of money that you will pay every month. So as and when they deduct the money from your accounts, it kind of builds the credit score. That is if and only if you have that amount of money in your account by the time the payment is due. So, you know, talking about this direct debit and making payments monthly, the basic and let me say the bottom line is you having the amount of money in your account as at the time the payment is due. If you don't have the money, that is when it becomes a problem. But obviously, if you are really, really into building your credit score, you just have to make sure the money is in your account for the payment to be made automatically for you every month. So another important, very, very important thing you can do to increase your credit score or to build your credit score is by having a credit card. So I do have an account at Barclays, that's a current account. And I've opened the savings account as well. And when I was opening the current account, they gave me a Visa card and a credit card. So I've got the Visa card, which is the normal debit card that everybody has. And I've also got this credit card. So at any point in time, so when you apply for the credit card, they give you a certain amount of money that you can use for anything, either to buy stuff in the shop, online, you can use it to buy anything on Amazon, eBay, whatever it is that you want to do. So instead of, if I go to a shop to buy something, instead of using the amount of money I have on this debit, I can use the credit card. So at the end of the month, whatever I've used, I just pay it back from this debit account. So I use the credit card not because I don't have money in my account, but I'm using it just to be able to build up a credit score, because when they realize that you're using the credit card, all right, and every month you pay whatever amount you've used, it definitely builds up the credit score. So this month, for instance, I had used like £195 from this credit card. So the moment I got paid my salary, I transferred it back onto this credit card. So I have like £800 on this credit card. And by the end of the month, whatever amount I've used, if it's like £200, I pay it back onto this credit card, and then my account goes back to £800. So I normally try to pay it off and not pay half, you know, because if you pay half, it's like you're owing them and then they start charging you interest and all that. So I normally don't do that. And I've also got another credit card, which is American Express. I don't know if you've lived here and build like a good credit score, you can apply for American Express, because if you apply for this, you don't only build up your credit score, you also get points. You build up points for like British Airways, and if you refer people, you get points, which adds up to your British Airways points. And if you are buying a plane ticket, you might get like a discount on that. So getting a debit card plus getting a credit card actually builds your credit score. So as and when you use, you just transfer from your debit back to the credit account, you know, just keep doing that every single month. And that really, so I've used this for almost 2 years now, so at least I'm building up the credit score gradually. So this is something I would definitely advise you to do. So if you have a current account and have not yet applied for a credit card with your bank, kindly making that application, and if you are lucky and they offer you the credit card, good, start using that instead of the debit, so that you just be transferring the money as and when you are paid, or as and when they, and also definitely when the payment is due, it will show you on your phone app that you are due to make this payment at this time, and make sure you pay it even before the time if you can. Don't wait until after, because if you delay payment, then it starts affecting the credit score again. So the last thing I would like to talk about is opening and managing accounts. So obviously, if you migrated here on a tier 2 visa to work, definitely you have a current account where you receive your monthly salary. But then you can also open like a private savings account where you can transfer money from your current account into the account, just like a savings account, basically. So I have a current account with Barclays, and I have another savings account with HSBC. So every now and then, you just transfer a few coins into that savings account. So as and when you are able to manage that current account plus a savings account, it all builds up your credit score, because definitely they will go into all that and they will know that, oh, you are managing two accounts. You are able to transfer money in and out of accounts. You are making transactions. It's not like a dormant account that has been there for 2-3 years. No. I mean, if a lender wants to check your credit history and you've opened a savings account that has been there for like 3 years, no money in it, nobody will think you are credible enough for them to give you their money. But if you open the savings account and you put in and withdraw money every now and then, they see that it's indeed like a running account, that will let them, like, it will prove to them that you are really credible when it comes to finance, and that can actually make them trust you. So all of this will build up your credit score. So if you've really enjoyed this video, if this has been insightful, like it, share with others, because some of these tips that I'm sharing with you, I never knew of them until recently. So if I had knew some of this way back, I believe my credit score would have been high by now. So if you've been here for a very long time and you don't know how to check your credit score, so there is an app called Experian. So that is what I use. I downloaded the app on my phone. I entered a few details and then it started calculating my credit score. So my credit score now is fair. So it's from good, fair, and then excellent. So gradually I'm building it up, and I want to share all of these tips with you so that you can also start building it up. Because if you ever wish to apply for a mortgage, they will definitely check your credit score. Some people may save enough for us as deposits even to apply for a mortgage, but then they forget to be building up their credit score. So you may go to a bank thinking, oh, I've got enough money to pay a deposit for a house, but then they will check your credit score and they realize you don't even have any credit history at all, although you have the deposit, all right, but they might wonder how you make payment, you know. So they might be a bit skeptical giving you the money. So if this is something you've not done before, try and then start doing it and build up your credit score right from now. Share with others and please subscribe to the channel and join the family. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.